In this video, we'll take a look at whether you should report p is less than 0.05 or p is greater than 0.05 in a given situation. In hypothesis testing, a common question I receive, as I said before, is whether to state p is less than 0.05 or p is greater than 0.05. The answer to this question is, it really depends. It depends on whether the results are statistically significant or not. Let's go ahead and take a look at this next. So suppose that we ran a statistical test and we obtained results that were statistically significant. If this was the case, then we would reject the null hypothesis. So when the results are statistically significant, we state p is less than 0.05. Or in other words, when we reject the null hypothesis, we state p is less than 0.05. And this assumes that an alpha of 0.05 is used. When we use an alpha 0.05, that's why we state p is less than 0.05. If we used an alpha of 0.01 and the test was statistically significant, then we would state p is less than 0.01. And for those who are interested, we'll get into the technical details about why we state p is less than 0.05 in just a few moments. So in summary, for statistically significant results, we want to state p is less than 0.05. If, on the other hand, we obtained results that were not statistically significant, we would fail to reject the null hypothesis. When the results are not statistically significant, we state p is greater than 0.05. So in summary, for non-significant results, we state p is greater than 0.05. Technically speaking, the p-value, like when we state p is less than 0.05, it indicates the probability, and that's what p stands for, probability, of getting our results, or results even more extreme, if the null hypothesis was true. When we say p is less than 0.05, we're declaring that the probability of getting the results we obtained is less than 0.05 or 5% if the null hypothesis was true. And this makes the result significant, as it occurs less than 5% of the time by chance alone. So this is why we state with significant results that p is less than 0.05, because the chance or probability of getting such results is less than 5%. On the other hand, getting non-significant results indicates that the probability of getting the specific results we obtained is greater than 0.05 or 5% if the null hypothesis was true. This is why with non-significant results we say p is greater than 0.05, because the chance of getting such results is greater than 5%. If you've gotten this wrong or been confused about this before, don't be discouraged, as this is one of the most common questions, or really mistakes, that I see made in statistics. I get a lot of questions about this, and a lot of people get it backwards. So just try to remember here, for significant results, you want to state p is less than 0.05, and this is when you reject the null hypothesis. So if you get statistically significant results, you put p is less than 0.05. And then for non-significant results, you just put the opposite, p is greater than 0.05. And in this case, this is when you fail to reject the null, or you accept the null, as some people say. And just as a reminder, if you were to use alpha of 0.01, then you would say p is less than 0.01, or p is greater than 0.01, depending on whether you got significant or non-significant results, respectively. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching.